What is going on, guys? Prestige here, and I got a quick guide on how to earn the 30-point achievement, Awaken the Gazebo. This is going to have you pack a punch a weapon on round one without using the bank or the weapon locker, and this is easier said than done. And I've seen a lot of tutorials here on YouTube that are just so drawn out and confusing and hard to follow, so I decided to make my own. In this tutorial, you're going to be able to do it in under 10 minutes, and you'll also have an extra 3,000 points at your disposal to use the mystery box and get a good weapon to go through the house without getting hit, or just having an extra 2,000 points to go through the house, and just in case you do get hit, you'll be able to still make it through and have enough points to hit the pack-a-punch machine. So let's go ahead and just start it off right here. And a lot of tutorials will tell you to kill the zombies upstairs. Well, we're not going to do that. We're just going to head straight down to the Remington drawable and get our 1,000 bonus points for drawing that on the wall. The zombies are going to come in handy more down here in the town than they would up there on the surface. So don't worry about them for the time being. We're not even going to kill anything at this point. So just go ahead, unlock the sloth out of his cage, or the giant, whatever you want to call him. You're going to need the big guy. So he's going to come in handy for about, I don't know, 85% of the points you earn on this. So little do people know, breaking down barriers will actually earn you points. So give him the booze, let him break down the first barrier, and then head over to the saloon and open that door. If the booze doesn't spawn in the saloon for you, you're going to have to head back to the cage and pick it up there from where you just picked it up to get him out of the cage the first time. And that's actually what happened to me. I don't know if I ran away from it too quick or something where it just spawned over there again, or if it just spawns there two times in a row for some reason, but it spawned back in his cage, and you're going to need to grab this really fast. So just get the booze and make him follow you to some place that's as far away as possible from the barrier, because the farther you are away from a barrier, the more points you're going to get. So say you're inside the gunsmith shop, or you're standing right here at the porch of the gunsmith shop. If you send him over to the juggernaut machine and try to break that barrier from this distance, you're actually going to be able to earn more than 1,000 points, or more than maybe 2,000 points if you're inside the gunsmith shop. So right there, I earned 1,700 points just off that barrier break. And with this method, you're going to be spending points to earn points. And it sounds kind of confusing at first, but what you're going to try to do is just break as many barriers as you can. And this is going to sound kind of confusing because I've heard people say when the sloth runs over the zombies after he's charging towards a barrier, they die out and they die forever. But I haven't experienced that. The zombies down here in this pathway to the gunsmith shop actually helps the sloth path his way to that barrier. So if you're all the way back here and you give him booze, and I'll actually run behind him to show you. If you're back here and you give him booze and there's zombies on the left side, he's going to move sort of like a football player where he uses his shoulders to kind of shove the zombies out of the way. And after they were kind of taken out, they'll respawn back in the map. I don't know why they don't die out, but they just respawn. I don't know if that's supposed to happen, but it just does work like that. So at this point, we already have the juggernaut open. We have the we have the gunsmith open, and now we're going to open up the door to get to the courthouse and to the church. So as you've seen right there, I actually shot a zombie to death, and that's going to be a key example right there. If I were to shoot him four times in knife like other tutorials tell you to, you would end up picking up that nuke, and you would have killed off all the zombies on round one, and the achievement would have been lost, and you would have had to restart the game. But I've been getting pretty lucky on getting these really far distance kills or long distance barrier breaks with the booze here, and you can just buy as much booze as you want. Now this is a prime example on why you want the zombies down here with you. Once they drop a double points, if they end up dropping a double points, this is a perfect time to pick up a chalk drawing and head over to any of the question marks and draw the chalk on the wall, because if you do that, instead of getting 1,000 points, you're going to get 2,000 points. The double points actually works for chalk drawings, which is something that is pretty cool, and at first I didn't know about it, but I am so glad that I learned about it, because that extra 1,000 points comes in handy so much that, you know, you're going to need as many points as you can get, and just with this method it's really easy to do. So right here, all I'm really doing is breaking down barriers, waiting for the sloth, and just trying to break out as many barriers as I can. So far, so good. This achievement is kind of yours already. I mean, you can see I already got 5,000 points. Once I give him this booze, he's going to go ahead and break down that barrier. And you got to keep in mind that the door to open the mansion is actually 1250. So make sure you're getting enough points. Make sure you're always getting more than 1,000 points every time you break down a barrier. Because if you're spending 1,000 to buy booze and then you break down a barrier and only earn like 300 or 400 points, you just lost points. But if you spend 1,000 for booze and then you get maybe 1,070 points like I just did on the mansion door, I just earned 70 points. So I'm not losing any points right there. So that's, I mean, the only way I can really explain it. If you end up losing points for some sort of reason and you're in a big struggle and you don't know how to get those points back, just go ahead and take a bottle of booze, go into the church where I just broke down the doors, and if you go all the way to the podium at the front of the church, you can take the booze and shoot him all the way to the fountain. He'll break that fountain. You'll get points for that as well. Also, there's a barrier right here between the barn stable and the weapon shop. You can go as far back over by the orb that's part of the Easter egg, and you can go ahead and shoot him to that barrier as well and earn like 1,700 points. So this is the part of the tutorial where you're going to draw as many weapons as you can. And at this point, I only have like 2 zombies left or 3 zombies left, and I'm just letting them roam because I kind of figured some certain points when I'm going through the mansion, sometimes the zombies will die out. It kind of sucks. But this is the most important piece right here, and I've actually forgot about doing this. You need to turn the power on in order to use the pack-a-punch machine. So make your way through the barn. Come through the caverns all the way through the back. Make sure you pick up a chalk drawing before you go this way, because this actually prevents you from buying the stairs in the saloon, so you don't have to use the 750 points on the stairs to move the sofa. When you're running this path, you only have to worry about this one jump. No floor will break out under you. Just go ahead and draw the question mark here on the wall. And then you're just going to do a 180 and jump over to the building across, and you'll be able to turn on the power for free. And this is actually a nice thing to notice when trying to save as much points as you can. So head back down to the gunsmith again. Just keep picking up all the drawings and taking them to their positions. So I'll just go ahead and list out the positions really quick. You can find the question mark. One of the question marks are on the jail cell. The second one will be on the top of the stairs where the buildable is, right when you spawn in, right where the mystery box is. The next question mark will be in the church area right here on the top. Then the next question mark you can find over in the courthouse, which is upstairs as well over by the sleight of hand machine. And then the final question mark you could find would be where I did the Galfinuckles right before I jumped to the power machine, or right to the power switch. And that's pretty much all of them. And then after you build the very last, or after you draw the very last chalk drawing, that will give you 2,000 points. So instead of a 1,000, you'll get 2,000. I have not tested it with the double points. If you do the last chalk drawing with the double points, I don't know if you get 4,000, but that would be awesome, and I don't see why not, just because the double points does work with it. So right here, we're going to go ahead and draw the last chalk drawing before we head all the way over to the mansion and get our fears all going. So we basically got almost 10,000 points. I'm going to risk it, hit the mystery box. The teddy bear was on top of it because I got the perma perk. I end up drawing the Mark II, and this is probably one of the best weapons to go through the mansion with, just because it's a one-shot kill. Now, I nearly have 9,000 points at my disposal, and if I really wanted to, I could go fix some barriers and get 9,000 points, but I'm not concerned at that at the point. So what I'm going to do is open this door. It's going to cost 1250, and I'm still going to have 7,000 points. So if I end up getting hit once, they're going to take 2,000 points, but I won't have to worry about it. So there's actually a little technique to taking out these girls right here. So at the top of the stairs, there's going to be one on your left. If you kill that, move up. There might be one on the right, but if you move fast enough, there might not be one there. Once the bookcase opens, there's always going to be one coming through right away. Once you're headed down the bookshelf way or through the narrow hallway, there's always going to be one coming towards you. Then once you turn your corner, there's always going to be one there. If you move fast enough, there'll be one at the end of the hallway. And then after that, just jump over the barrier there and just run for it. You have to make it through the maze. The witches are still chasing you at this point, so just try to find your way through the maze as fast as possible. If you have to, check your back, because they do follow you. They are kind of slow, so you don't have to really worry about them too much. So After this, you're home free. Get down the stairs, put it in the pack-a-punch machine, and you are golden. Awaken the Gazebo is your achievement. 30 points, and that's pretty much it. You got the Mark Gun, the Ray Gun Mark II. The witches are making their way down here. You'll get your free perk. Awaken the Gazebo is all yours, guys. I hope you enjoyed this achievement guide. Under 10 minutes. If you did, please drop a like. If not, that's cool. And keep in mind, I'm on the road to 100,000 subscribers. We are literally almost there. If you would do me the favor and hit the subscribe button, it would really be appreciated. But until next time, I am out. Peace.